1, 2, 3, 4.
If you're gonna go out on two wheels,
put on your helmet,
get good shoes,
check your brakes,
oil your chain,
pump up your tires,
wear bright clothes,
look out for walkers,
bring a good lock,
drink lots of water,
and have a ton of fun.
Woo!
Welcome to Bike Life, where we talk to people about their bikes and lives, and we play bike music too. I'm Kai Plaskon of the Truckee Meadows Bicycle Alliance. You can find us at bikewasho.org. Now, if you're like me, you are always on the lookout for the right present for the right people throughout the entire year. At least that's what I do. Cycling gear is really, really special. It can be as unique as the cyclists themselves. Today, we're going to talk about bike bling and bike gear, and we're also going to focus on music from around the world about bikes. Before we get to that, let's get an update on Reno area bike news. E-bike and scooter share are coming to Reno. Last month, the Reno City Council tentatively approved a contract with the company Bird. The Truckee Meadows Bicycle Alliance originally made the introduction in May of 2021 between Bird and the city, and that introduction has now paid off. It's a game changer to have scooter and bike share in Reno. Bikes and scooter share are going to be used by tourists, employees, people who use public transit, students, and just regular residents of Reno. It's going to reduce traffic problems, parking problems, vehicle emissions, and it's going to contribute to the economy. The last time we had bike share here in Reno, it was kind of an experiment. There were 140,000 rides in just 1 year. How are all these people on scooters going to get around safely? Well, there's a new alternative transportation safety survey. It's available for Washoe County residents now, and it's to inform city and county leaders what people are looking for with regards to safe infrastructure. So far, more than 70 people have filled out the survey in less than a month, and we're expecting to keep it running perpetually on various government websites, as well as our website, bikewasho.org. So just go to bikewasho.org and you can fill out the survey. You're going to find it right at the top of the screen. Speaking of safe infrastructure, here's an update on the Center Street Protected Bike Path development in downtown Reno. The Row casinos have been trying to stop it, remember? They want to move this bike path that's in development to Virginia Street in front of their casinos. The Regional Transportation Commission has the traffic analysis on how the path would impact traffic in the downtown area, but they haven't released it yet to the Truckee Meadows Bicycle Alliance, and they promised to do that by November 30th. So it's more than a month late. The executive director says it's in internal review, and they will share it with the Alliance after that review, and they haven't provided a new estimate for when it'll be released. New research from the University of Colorado shows the positive impact bicycling has on health outcomes, finding that more than 200,000 premature deaths, around 15,000 in the United States alone, could be prevented each year if countries supported more urban bicycling by 2050. 200,000 premature deaths could be prevented. It's amazing. Oh, that's enough news. The background music that we've been listening to is Frank Ocean, FTJZ, Bicycling Instrumental. Before we get to our interviews today about how people bling out their bikes and their favorite bike gear, let's listen to some more bike music, international music about bicycles. That's what we're doing on today's show with the music. Here is Beanie Man Bicycle Man by Saab Waits.
Loudest one. He's a special dedicated to all the bicycle man, them man. Especially to a man, seven man gang, Easy Papa and Devon. Love the nature, dear Michael. Love the bicycle man, not the day by bicycle man, burn them in the bicycle man, not the day by bicycle man, come again, no, no bicycle man, not the day by bicycle man, burn them in the bicycle man, not the day by bicycle man, to be a begin that he in a one gang, to ride bicycle as a man champion. Reference to your dome, computer wild from your dose. One wheel, wheel, lily, wheelie, run a van. Balls, if to what they done. Put up on your two wheel lift like champion. With a long wheel, rule living, what come they say. Bicycle, man, not fit they bicycle. Let me burn up, let me bicycle, they not fit they bicycle. Man, come again, no, no bicycle, man, not fit they bicycle. Man, burn up, let me bicycle, man, not fit they bicycle. Man, say pretty bicycle, have an headlamp. And we leave it the bicycle man no business. Sit up on top of the top of the top of the with my version. Up on top of the wheel man we don't want say don't it not fit the bicycle man not fit the bicycle man burn them in the minute. Bicycle man not fit the bicycle man go. Bicycle man not fit the bicycle man burn them in the minute. Bicycle man not fit the bicycle man. Keep it the it bicycle in and the gang. It's red right papaya and I rise at the van. Easy than the devil, cause you know you want it done. Come, big, big, big to the one, my color. Easy that the body, at the oldest one. Easy that the egg, at the catch, you come on, don't be busy. The top of the top of the top of the video, and first and the big nose, suit with them call Bantan. Who ride the Rambo? I man, the name, and I'm with the bicycle man, I'm with the bicycle man, burn them in the minute. Bicycle man, I'm with the bicycle man, free them in the minute. Bicycle man. Bicycle man, I fit there. Bicycle man, no habit. Kiss up your bicycle, keep it prime. 10 speed, lot it up, it fast all the time. You fit, roll if I bike up, fast I go, send up with the bicycle man. Bicycle man, to me, send a leg on a car. Fly left, I'm on. Look on that little one, you should want to put the verse on. I man, I pick up with the bicycle man. I myself, I am a bicycle man, no fit the bicycle man, not fit the bicycle man, burn them in them. Bicycle man, not fit the bicycle man, burn them in them. Bicycle man, not fit the bicycle man, burn them in them. Bicycle man, not fit the bicycle man. In America, London, say Canada, and in a Jamaica land. I man, send respect to all bicycle man. I love on the world, and in the island, I know all over in a day. Bicycle man, burn them in them. Bicycle man, I feel the bicycle man, fuck man. Bicycle man, bicycle man, burn them in them. Bicycle man, I feel the bicycle man. Come, who a ride bicycle? No fat man, the slim man, and manga man. Don't get to the beat, this bicycle man. Do so don't want the ready man, no bandy verse.
That was Beanie Man Bicycle Man by Saab Waits. Made me want to dance. So the Bike Life Radio interviews today are all about bike gear and bling. I put these interviews together on the fly at the Radical Adventure Riders meetup at Gear Hut in Reno. Radical Adventure Riders collects used bike gear and donates it to people who need it. We have a new bike rider and a very seasoned bike rider among our interviews today. And my favorite part of the show is when we talk about bike seats, and that's coming up in a little bit. It's a very intimate part of the bike that we are all very familiar with, right? The seat. But first, let's chat with Nicole, who recently started riding, and she talks about her bike bling. What's your name?
Nicole.
Nicole? And you have a pink helmet on.
I do, yeah.
And you're at Gear Hut.
I am.
Yeah.
And why are we here?
We're here for the RAR...
Reno Adventure Riders. Yeah,
yeah,
rawr. And so you've come down here to do what?
Just to hang out and be social and see what's going on.
That's awesome. Thank you for coming down here. Truckee Meadows Bicycle Alliance is here too. And we're talking today at Gear Hut. And since we're at Gear Hut, we're going to talk about gear. Does that sound reasonable?
Perfect, yeah.
All right, good. And so one of the pieces of gear that you're wearing is a pink helmet. Is that your favorite piece of bike gear?
It actually is. I was going to choose it, yeah.
Yeah, you're wearing it like it's like a fashion statement right now.
Yeah, I actually match my outfits to the helmet. It's a lot, but I love it.
Right on. So you took your, and it's like a light pink helmet.
It is, yeah. It's like baby pink.
Yeah. And so how did you match your helmet to what you're wearing? What else you're wearing?
I just kind of look at the colors. I like to wear things that are bright, you know, high vis for being on the bike, but also things that... you know, kind of coordinate with each other and my bag. It's just a whole process.
Excellent. High vis. What does that mean?
You know what? My partner says it. I think it just means like high visuals. Like it's easy for people to see you on the bike at night or in the day, just anytime really.
visibility.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's important to be seen when you're out there, right? Like, you're not just trying to look cool, but you're trying to look cool so that people see you and don't hit you with their car and kill you.
Right. Yeah. Especially as a new rider, sometimes, you know, maybe I'm not doing quite the right thing. So it's really important that people see me.
Yeah. A new rider, huh? When did you start riding a bike?
I'd say maybe about 3 months ago. I rode bikes as a kid, but I think that's a pretty common experience. And then for like 20 years, I didn't ride one.
Do you have any other favorite pieces of gear?
Probably my bottle cage is in the shape of a lucky cat, and I just think it's really cute.
Really?
Yeah.
Let's go look at it.
Yeah.
You're about to go right away anyway, huh?
That's true, yeah. Yeah.
All right, so you've got your bike over here in front of the gear hut. Oh, wow. Which one? Okay, I got a guess.
Okay.
All right. Oh, it's not that one. I was initially going to say that one over there, which has a whole lot of things all over it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's very attractive to me to have so many things all over the bicycle. But that is not your bike. Yours is the, like, super yellow.
Yes.
Is that yellow or what is that color?
We call it yellow. Sometimes we call it green. It can really go either way. It's pretty bright.
Huh. And it's a KHS Urban Escape. Nice. And so let's describe your water bottle cage there. Let's get a little closer.
Oh, it's inspect. Oh, yeah. So it's a little lucky cat. He's a white lucky cat. His right paw is up, and then the left paw is like the part that forms the bottle cage. And you actually just put the bottle in from the side and slide it in. So it's really easy to grab when you're like on the road. I can't quite do that yet, but most people probably could.
Neat. So you like it not just because of the way that it looks, but it's also very functional for you.
Correct. Yeah. I used it on the way here, and I'm going to use it later this week as well.
Yeah, but you probably do every time you ride your bike.
Exactly. Yeah, I actually don't switch it out because it's so cute. Like, I have another one that I could use, but this one's just so much better.
Excellent. And I see that you've also got a thing on your seat post to hold your pant leg in so it doesn't get caught in the chain, right?
Correct. Yeah, one of the RAR girls actually just gave that to me, so I'm excited to use it.
And have you ever had your pants caught in the chain?
No, but actually just today my shoelace got caught like on the way here, so I need to be better about tying them.
Or you need a shoelace holder.
Is that a thing?
No.
Oh, I was excited.
Me too for a minute.
Yeah, I was like, oh, we're doing this now? Okay, I can dig it.
You know, I think I've tried before to use my shoelaces as a pant leg holder, which kind of solves both issues. But you know what? I think I ended up getting my shoelace caught in the chain when I used my shoelace as a pant leg holder. So I've tried,
yeah,
you know, and that's,
curious.
I think that's one of the interesting things about riding a bike is there's all kinds of experimentation going on all
yeah.
the time with
mm-hmm.
gear, right? Like,
yeah.
And you got to make things work sometimes if you're like me and you're not going to try to spend any money on anything.
Right, I feel that. It's funny because when I got here I was talking about my saddle and one of the RAR girls actually helped me fix it, so it's more tilted back now, so we'll see how it is on the ride home.
It's tilted back, so
mm-hmm.
it was tilted down before?
It was kind of, yeah, I'd say tilted down or maybe even more parallel, but I didn't really like where I was sitting, so it's just moved up a little bit and I'm gonna see. I guess you move it up like degree, like very gradual.
Huh. We're chatting with Nicole about how she has blinged out her bike and her favorite bike gear. Makes it real fun. And we're going to pick up our conversation again about bike seats when we come back, and a very special kind of bike seat that you may not know about. Before we get to that, I want to share this next song from a South African choir that teaches kids about bikes.
Can you do the bicycle dance? Can you do the bicycle dance? Come on, try it. Come on. Can you do the bicycle dance? Can you do the bicycle dance? Come on. Try it. Come on.
Go 1940. Go 1940. Squela marabi siki bela mapai siki.
Station, we get on and ride.
bicycle, bella my bicycle.
That was the South African Choir with a song to teach kids about bikes. Before the break, we were talking to Nicole about her bike seat. The seat is the most intimate part of the bike, really. Sarah was nearby, and she wanted to talk about her very special bike seat, among other things. So now, since we're talking about seats, and I noticed on this other bike over here, on this Surly, mm-hmm. I want to tell you about something in case you don't know.
Oh, yeah.
Do you know anything about these kinds of seats?
I don't.
Okay, so this isn't Sean's bike, right? It's your bike. Okay. Well, and what's your name?
Sarah Jane.
Sarah, come over here, Sarah. We're talking about seats, and hers was not pointed correctly.
Ooh.
But then that made me look at this seat over here because I was looking at the angle, right? And
yep.
And it's an awesome seat, like one of the most awesomest I've ever heard. And I've never ridden on one, but just the description of like how it like becomes a part of your body, you know, is neat.
It's a painful process to get there, though. I'll tell you that. Yeah.
Really?
Oh, yeah. 500 miles before you break it in.
Wow.
Oh. Yeah. So you work hard for those miles to make it fit to your butt.
Huh. So that is really the shape of the inside of your butt, isn't it?
Really
that seat.
Yeah. I worked very hard for what you see here.
So you've ridden on that for 500 miles already.
Yes, really? I have. Yeah.
Wow. That's amazing. All right. We're looking at this turquoise seat. I'm sure there's lots of people who are trying to imagine. A Brooks Colt. What? Okay, so I've heard of Brooks before. It is Colt. Is Colt somehow different?
It was like a limited edition Brooks that they launched at some point. It just looked really pretty, and I always wanted a Brooks saddle, and it matched. So here I am.
They're like $1,000. No, not really, but they're expensive.
They're expensive as hell. I paid too much for that. Not $1,000, but a lot.
Like so much that she doesn't even want to say.
No, yeah,
yeah, it's somewhere. But it's worth it. No pun intended, but it's worth it. Get it? Yeah.
Good one.
Thank you. I'm proud of that one. So do you think you're going to get one? It's Nicole, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think so. It's really pretty. I am a little scared about the price since nobody seems to want to talk about it, but I really like the way it looks.
And you can get other Brooks that aren't, you know, the Colt, for example, mm-hmm. that are much more affordable.
Okay.
There's lots of different models, lots mm-hmm. of strong opinions out there, mm-hmm. but, you know, it's an investment. So that's cool.
For sure. Yeah. And you do use it every time you're on the bike. So it's mm-hmm. like, it's never going to mm-hmm. go to waste.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah, and so how has that saddle changed your life, would you say?
Oh, wow. I think this whole bike has changed my life. Mm-hmm. So as part of it, I hadn't been on a bike for 10 years. I did the AIDS life cycle from San Francisco to LA about 12 years ago. And then I just kind of put away my road bike and got invested in other stuff and wanted an adventure bike. And having a saddle that feels comfortable has been an important part of it. And
but for like 500 miles, you were like, I'm really uncomfortable. Right?
Yeah. Yeah, but I was also like, this is a fraction of like the thousands of miles I hope to get on this.
This saddle will be with you your whole life.
Yeah, it better be.
Yeah. And, did you take off the quick release on it so that nobody could steal your saddle?
Yes, I did.
But wouldn't that be weird if like somebody stole your saddle after you've already broken it in and then they're like, oh, this feels really weird.
Especially because like, I don't know, I have a unique butt. So like, I just don't think that it's going to work for most people.
Everybody's butt's unique.
It's true. It's true. Yeah. So like, I don't know, people buy used Brooks saddles, which is interesting to me. And even at 500 miles, there's still like a lot of wear you can get. So I also was like, this is going to have good resale value, even if I hate it. So, you know, I thought through this, but
maybe it's worth like $2,000 now because it's shaped to your butt.
I mean, there's some weirdos out there. I should get more money for it, really.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Yes. Yes. It's broken in.
It's true.
You know, a little secret that I learned, speaking of like breaking these things in. Uh-huh. Right. I think the same thing is true with shoes. And I'm like the farthest thing from an expert on this. But I do have a little bit of experience with running shoes where I'll go to. I just recently got these Birkenstocks. I'm really happy about them. They're already shaped to my feet, kind of, sort of.
Exactly.
I would go to the Goodwill and I would buy my running shoes there. Uh-huh. And people think that that's a silly idea. But the fact is that everybody's feet are a different shape. So shoes might be broken in for some other person, but they're not broken in for me. And so there's still a lot of good foam in there that's useful for me as a runner. And maybe it's the same thing as a seat, like, or for a Brooks saddle. They're made out of leather, for anybody else who's kind of wondering. And so, and they're super stiff looking, like no, most people are like, oh, I want a real soft saddle, but this is really hard. And when you sit on it, then it's going to shape to your butt. And, you know, since everybody's butt is different, if I were to sit on that one, then it would eventually have to shape to my butt. Mm-hmm. It would change shape. Yeah. And,
Another 500 miles. It could be a totally different saddle.
And so if somebody did buy it, though, they might, like, curse you for a while. They're like, oh, God, like, her butt is really weird.
Yeah, her butt is not my butt. And this is, like, I got to get it to fit my butt. Yeah, exactly. For sure.
Well, I'm really glad that we had a chance to talk about this saddle, and you learned a lot, didn't you, Nicole?
I did, yeah. Yeah,
so good luck on getting one. You want to go for a run, I think, I heard you say, and you're going to ride your bike to where you're going to go for a run, right?
Correct, yes.
Yeah, all right. Well, we'll let you go. Thank you for chatting with us. And good luck with your water bottle, and have a lot of fun riding.
Thank you. I appreciate that. It was good to be here.
We'll talk to you soon. But I'm not done with you and your saddle yet.
Okay.
So do you have a favorite piece of bike gear? Is it the saddle?
Oh, well, the saddle's one of the faves for sure.
You've got all this multicolored stuff, like handlebar tape.
Aesthetics. That's important.
Aesthetics.
Yeah, cute bike.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Nice.
I don't know. If you're going to go there and spend a lot of time on a bike, you probably want to be kind of excited about how it looks. I like the color coordination thing I got going on here. And also, it was kind of my dream adventure bike, so I went big.
You've got quite a bit of really interesting stuff on it. Like, your kickstand is not just a single kickstand, it's a double kickstand.
Talk about nerdy, right? Yeah. And you know why I have that is I have a dog bike trailer.
I see the trailer thing on the bottom. Yeah, and so you would have your dog in the trailer, and then you don't want the bike to fall over and then dog to fall out, and then it would be just a disaster.
Exactly. Yeah, he was supposed to come today, but I didn't have my pin. I couldn't find it for the trailer, so next time. But yeah, for that, and then also eventually, for longer trips, I anticipate having some bags on here, and so I kind of figured, all right, this will help me hold it all together.
So you want to have some bags on here. I want to describe your Surly bike here for a minute. We already talked about the saddle. Why don't you talk a little bit about from back to front of what you've got going on here?
Oh, man, I'll do my best. Okay. I will say this bike was built for me by a good friend out in Arcata who owns a queer-owned bike shop called Moon Cycles. And it's an old friend of mine, and I had discussed with them, like, I want a good adventure bike. I had had my heart set on a Surly Crosscheck in particular. Crosschecks weren't being made for a while because I don't know why. So it was actually very hard to find one in my size because I'm pretty short. But I found one. I wanted a steel frame that would last me a long time. So it's a steel frame Surly Crosscheck. It's a tealish, grayish color. I've got a front basket with a Surly rack on it and a back basket here where you can put a back bag on it. I've got some Panaracer tires on it. So these are sort of gravel tires. What else do we have?
Yeah, they're nice big wide tires.
They're also pink. That's important. I've got some fun iridescent bar tape and some sort of wide bars. They're salsa bars. So those are fairly common in the gravel riding adventure bike scene, I guess. They sort of allow you to kind of sit up straight, but you can also kind of get down in the bars if you're climbing.
Neat. Yeah, it's a gorgeous bike.
Thank you.
Yeah. And so you like to have a front basket because you could grab stuff.
Exactly, yep. I've got a little bag on there. My bags are from Swift. They're out of Seattle. I've got a net, cargo net, so I can just throw stuff in there as I want to.
Ooh, a cargo net. That way, that when you go over a big bump, it doesn't fly out and smash you in the face.
Yep. Totally.
Yeah. I had that happen with my coffee the other day. I recently put a little cup holder on the front, and I thought, this is going to be wonderful. I'll be able to use my hands and carry my coffee.
Yeah.
But then I hit a big bump, and the coffee flew out of the cup holder and then, like, all over my body and smashed onto the ground. And it was, like, 5 a.m. in the morning, and I was like, oh, my God. And then today, I don't have a really good cover, so I've got, like, I don't know, the coffee splashed all over my legs while I was riding. So you really need one with a lid on it and some kind of a bungee cord.
Yeah.
And since we're talking about gear,
yes.
I guess that's appropriate.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Well, I'm glad I snuck that in there.
we're going to bring it full circle here.
we're at Gear Hut, and what people are donating stuff here today, right? Yeah.
Yes.
For what?
So we have a chapter here in Reno called the Radical Adventure Riders. This is part of a national network. I think we're one of 11. This is the first year that there have been chapters, and we're committed to equity in the bicycle adventure scene. So racial equity and gender inclusivity. Part of what we want to do is address barriers to bike packing and bicycle safety. So we're working on a gear library, which we're going to be doing in partnership with probably a couple different local bike organizations. And the goal will be for us to be able to have, basic things like lights, multi-tools, reflectors, hand pumps for folks that are needing those to be able to ride safe on their bike, as well as a bike lending library for bike packing and bike touring adventures. So we are soliciting donations of gently used gear for those, so that having access to gear that can be pretty expensive, so that that's not a barrier.
Yeah, so speaking of gear, as a cyclist who's done it for a long time, I have a lot of it. Like, and there's like just piles of it in places and just thrown wherever.
Yeah.
And I'm not alone, am I?
No, you're not.
Are you a closet hoarder of bike things too?
You know, yes.
Or do you just readily admit it?
You know, yes and no. Because bikes are kind of coming back into my life after many years without them, I still had a random box of gear kind of stored away. I don't
so
have
you were
a ton
like
of
someday
it.
I'll use that.
Yeah, exactly.
And why did you stop riding a bike? Yeah.
Grad school.
Really?
I just got busy. I got other interests. I lived in LA. I wasn't super excited about riding a bike there. And then it wasn't until I moved to Reno a few years ago that I was like, oh man, I want a bike. I used to just do road cycling. And I really wanted a bike that could handle kind of all terrain. Yeah.
So how did you do in grad school?
Good.
You did well?
Yeah. Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
I study public health. Timely.
I like to think that people do better at everything when they ride a bike.
Yeah. I totally agree with you.
So I'm disappointed. that you did not ride a bike during grad school, and you would have done better.
I probably would have. Yeah, it's true.
Not that you didn't do well, but.
Yeah, you know, it's just one of those things that kind of fell off. Our interests shift over time, and now is the time to come full circle and come back to bikes, so.
Yep. Back to reality.
Back to reality. Bikes can be incorporated into everything that we do.
Yeah, exactly. Like even radio.
Yeah, like look at us now.
Yes, excellent. Oh, look at this. What is this thing on the back of your bike?
It's
you have
a
is that
light.
A light? Really?
Yeah,
like a heart-shaped light. Wow.
And it blinks.
That's amazing.
Oh, it can blink. It's got all the settings.
It can blink.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
Huh. So what do you think gets the most attention on your bike? What piece of gear?
That's a good question. I don't think that there's one particular piece. I think people are often just like, whoa, you really color coordinated this thing. And I'm like, yeah, it was my dream bike.
Yeah, so it's like the holistic, the whole of your bike that is attractive to people.
Yeah.
All of the gear.
Yes, and I think it's also kind of an archetype. People like a surly crosscheck. They're like, all right, standard steel bike, surly, solid. I'm like, yep.
Nice. I notice that your bell is in an odd location.
Mm-hmm.
Normally people have it on the handlebars and you've got yours strapped to your your neck of your bike or whatever
call
that. What is this called? The stem, right?
Stem? Or I always get these mixed up. Those are the bike mechanics over there. They'd know.
They're hearing us and they're like, oh my God, I can't believe they don't know what that's called.
The stem. All right, good.
That was a good guess.
Does one of you want to come talk about some things?
Shaking their head. Yes, come on over. Yes.
Yeah, let's have Lauren talk.
Lauren.
We'll see this.
Lauren's like, no, I'm on the computer. But but they're listening.
Me with another bike that I put together. And the Kiwanis Club has some really rad stuff. And both Shane and Lauren work there. And I've been learning about my bikes with the support of Lauren. So that's been really cool.
Excellent. All right. So Lauren has walked over here and she's like, I'll talk about gear, right? We're at Gear Hut and we're collecting gear and we have extra gear at home. And we know that people do too. So they should donate it to the Radical Adventure Riders. It's starting a new lending library. And Lauren is going to talk about her favorite piece of bike gear, right?
My favorite piece of bike gear?
Yeah, you're a mechanic, right?
Yes, I am a mechanic.
A bike mechanic?
Yes. I've been with Kiwanis Bike Program for the past 3 years. So I've learned a lot there. And
about gear?
Yes, about gear. When I first started riding, I would wear like yoga leggings, yoga tops, that kind of thing. And then I finally started wearing jerseys.
Was that because you were doing yoga while riding the bike?
No, it's just like what I had at home. I didn't really have any like proper bike clothing. And then I started and I was like, wow, like the padding in the shorts is like amazing. And then all the pockets in my jerseys, I can put in tools and water bottles and keys. And so I would say learning to like bicycle clothing was probably like that gear aspect took the longest, but was the most significant.
Yeah. And so that explains why we look so silly sometimes, doesn't it? Yeah.
Exactly.
Like giant pockets that are right above our butts and full of tons and tons of stuff. And it's so practical that it doesn't feel silly, but it certainly does look silly sometimes, doesn't it? And you didn't want to look silly, so you wore yoga clothes. And now you're like, okay, I'll look silly.
Yeah, and I also just didn't own any of it. And then I purchased a couple pieces, and I was like, all right, I see why people choose to wear these like clothing items while riding.
Excellent. All right, so do you have, I'm going to step over here into the shade because I'm getting sunburned in the hot Reno sun. Speaking of which, this is a great place to ride your bike in Reno year-round because we have so much sun and it's so dry and it doesn't rain hardly at all. It is a little cold, but it's normally warm and perfect for riding. So anyway, back to Lauren and your favorite piece of gear. Is it the clothing?
Ooh.
She's thinking.
I am thinking. It's a hard question.
Yeah. You know, because there are so many different things, but I think it's interesting that you brought up clothing. And I think that what's neat about gear is that it can sometimes be a surprise and it surprises you about how useful it is. You're like, I don't need that. And then you get it. And then you're like, wow, I needed this my whole life. My life was not complete without it.
Saddlebag.
Before we talk about the benefits of bike bags, let's take another break for some more international bike music. When I was looking for the music for this episode, I came across a playlist from India that has 64 bike songs. I think I may maybe play one on each show in the future, I'm not sure. But for now, here's song number 57 on that playlist, Babur Gaan Pedal Mari Mari.
Pedal mari 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 o khonti cycle cholai jam putuli eri 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 o khonti tumare ghor paam o pedal mari 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 o khonti cycle cholai jam putuli eri 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 o bhanti tumare ghor pa o tuli murote goi tumaloe bate sam ghor loi matile mukh bhitor loi khumai jam o duli eri 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 o bhanti tumare ghor pa Dusaku pirik 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 o phanti tumaloe sa Goli ja dhipis 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 zetiya tumaka khot pa Dusaku pirik 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 o phanti tumaloe sa Goli ja dhipis dipis 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 zetiya tumaka khot pa golapi dugalote moromore sumakham goli jat likha ase iti mathu tumar naam goli ja dipis 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 zetiya tumaka khot pa তোমাকে সুমি 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 হাকিম যেন কাখরতে উমি 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 বুকুতে পিরিতিরে জু তোমাকে সুমি 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 হাকিম যেন কাখরতে মরমর কথিয়ারে মনর পথার দিবাদুই হাহিয়ারু ধেমালিরে সকুলবুর নিবাদুই তোমাকে সুমি 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 থাকিম যেন কাখরতে কুই ও পেদল মারি 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 ও ভন্তি সাইকেল চলাই যাম eri 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 o bhanti tumare ghor pa o tuli murote goi tumaloe bate sam ghor loi matile mukh bhitor loi khumai jam o tuli eri 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 o bhanti tumare ghor pa o tuli eri 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 eri
That was Babur Gaan, Pedal Mari Mari. Part of the that's part of a 64 song Indian playlist where every song, every 64 songs is about bikes. Wow. So we're talking about bike gear on the show today in our interviews, and while it might sound boring, it's irresistible for bike enthusiasts. They just can't stop talking about it, but and it can be kind of embarrassing. Anyway, Lauren couldn't help but get in on the conversation. She was standing nearby.
Saddlebag, that's my favorite, because then it doesn't matter what I am wearing if I'm just going out for like a quick ride versus like a longer like 40, 60, whatever mile ride. Like the saddlebag gives you, I think, the most flexibility. You can just stuff a bunch of stuff in there. Doesn't really matter like what you wear. And I can have all my tools to fix things, money if I want to get coffee. So yeah, saddlebag.
Yeah, that's neat. So what's neat about a saddlebag is that you can carry everything in there permanently. Like you're like, I need to have a tube with me all the time, mm-hmm. and I can't fit it in a tiny little bag underneath my seat, or I need certain number of tools and it's stuff to fit it all in there, or a pump and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Do you have anything? You keep money in your saddlebag.
Yes.
Okay, shh, don't tell anybody, right?
Yeah. I know. Yeah, I try to keep like emergency cash in there. I'll put my card in there sometimes. Like you said, yeah, tube, tire levers, CO2 cartridges, because they're a lot easier to fill your like road tires up to a higher pressure.
Mm-hmm. Do you have a pump?
I have a floor pump at home, but I don't really have a pump that I put on my bike.
So I haven't ever used those CO2 cartridges because I'm just worried that I'll mess it up somehow and then I won't, like, all the air will escape from my CO2 cartridge and then I'll just be without any ability to pump up my tire. But you haven't had that problem though.
No, but I've been lucky. So I started riding in a group, and so some people there helped me learn how to use it, because yeah, if you puncture it and all the CO2 goes out, then you're like really out of luck. So I would say definitely practice at home. Make sure you have the right attachment piece between the cartridge and your like valve, whether it's Presta or Schrader. It's another big thing too.
So as a mechanic, you've seen a lot of bikes. Is there anything that's really interesting that you've seen over the years? You're like, wow, I've never seen something like that before. It was a piece of gear or something that was on a bike.
I've seen people put some really fun caps on their tube valve stems. I've seen some really fun things people screw on there. Sarah Jane has purple ones. And I've seen people put all sorts of little like figurines or skulls or like glowing lights. Yeah.
I used to have lights on mine. I think somebody stole them.
Oh, no.
Yeah. It was terrible. They were like, I don't know, the first ones ever made by anybody anywhere. And I had them on my bike, and then they got stolen. So that was one of my favorite pieces of gear, because that was unique and different. But thank you. Thanks for, if anything else comes to mind, let me know.
All right. Thank you.
Thanks. Shane really wants to talk about bike gear. He has a favorite piece of bike gear. You did too. You worked for NPR just like me, so now you have to do it.
It's not my jam, man.
It's not like that, no. He's like turning his head away. No, no. So do you have a favorite piece of bike gear?
I really don't want to do this, man.
You don't? Oh, man. All right. Well, I'll go find somebody else. Most people really want to talk about bikes. Did you know that? He doesn't, but he's a bike mechanic. Are you just really tired of talking about bikes? Eventually, the longer I stand here and talk to you, yeah, I know, I'm relentless. As he's still standing here, so eventually he's got to walk away, but he's refusing to. Okay, he's doing it. I gave him a hint. All right, well, I'll find somebody else to go talk to. Bye, Shane. That was Lauren and Shane. Shane is still a little embarrassed to talk about bike gear, but that's okay. They are both bike mechanics at the Kiwanis Bike Project in Reno. They fix bikes for kids and teach kids how to fix bikes. Incredible program. Look them up on Facebook, Kiwanis Bike Project in Reno. For our next piece of international bike music, here's Tokino no Mundo, La Serranca, A Bicicleta. Thank you.
sou eu que te levo pelos parques a correr. Te ajudo a crescer em duas rodas deslizar. Em cima de mim o mundo fica à sua mercê. Você roda em cima, o mundo embaixo de você. Corpo ao vento, pensamento solto pelo ar. Pra isso acontecer, basta você me pedalar. B-C-C-L-P-A, sou tua amiga bicicleta. B-C-C-L-P-A, sou tua amiga bicicleta. Sou eu que te faço companhia por aí, entre ruas, avenidas, na beira do mar. Eu vou com você comprar e te ajudar a curtir. Picolé, chiclete, figurinhas e gibi. Roda, roda, o tempo roda, é hora de voltar. Pra isso acontecer, basta você me pedalar. B-C-C-L-P-A, sou tua amiga bicicleta. B-C-C-L-P-A, sou tua amiga bicicleta. Faz bem pouco tempo entrei na moda pra valer. Os executivos me procuram sem parar. Todo mundo vive preocupado em emagrecer. Até mesmo teus pais resolveram me adotar. Muita gente ultimamente vem me pedalar, mas de um jeito estranho que eu não saio do lugar. B-C-C-L-P-A, sou tua amiga bicicleta. B-C-C-L-P-A, sou tua amiga bicicleta.
That was Tokino no Mundo da Ciranca a Bicicleta. Our interviews today were at Radical Adventure Riders event at Gear Hut, right? The Radical Adventure Riders collect and distribute used bike gear to people who desperately need it. And here's an idea. You can go over to Gear Hut, right, and find something better than what you have on your bike right now, right? And you could buy it and then donate the old parts to the Radical Adventure Riders. What a brilliant idea, Kai. Since I'm the only one here, I have to compliment myself every chance I get. So anyway, our next interview is with Timmy, an employee at Gear Hut who can help you find stuff. We're at Gear Hut and we're collecting stuff so that people who don't have stuff can have stuff when they ride their bike, if they want to ride their bike. And sometimes people don't ride their bikes because they don't have stuff. And so we're at Gear Hut. And what is Gear Hut and who are you?
So I'm Timmy. I'm just an employee here.
Say your name again.
Timmy.
Timmy. You're Timmy. You're not just an employee. You're like supervisor guy.
Yeah. So I'm the weekend supervisor here.
Don't undersell yourself.
Okay.
Yeah. So you're Timmy. And what is Gear Hut?
It's a consignment shop. We specialize in human-powered outdoor mountain sports. So anything from hiking to climbing to ice climbing and all the gear you need to get outdoors.
Neat. And it's like used stuff.
Yeah, so almost everything is secondhand. We do get like those few items that are brand new with tags. But yeah, for the most part, it's all used gear, secondhand store. No, so part of our consignment process is going through the gear with all the consigners that bring their stuff in. And part of it's just a quality control. If something's too torn up or beat up, we just ask them to go donate it to Goodwill or find a good way to recycle it.
Right on. Excellent. And you don't have a whole lot of bike stuff, but you do have a little bit of bike stuff. Like, what do you have that's bike related?
So we typically just take like panniers, mountain bike stuff. We don't have a huge demographic for bike equipment. We're trying to build that up before we take more. And in the summer, we do take full bike setups. So we'll take gravel riders and mountain bikes. We're really trying to reach road bike people. Not too many of them come in here looking for us. But other than that, we take like shoes, helmets, just like kind of the main gear that you need to get outdoors. Bike.
Huh. Wow. All right. And so, Timmy, do you have a bike?
I do, yeah.
What kind of bike?
So I have a Diamondback. I think it's a Line 27.5-inch. It's just a mountain bike.
Uh-huh. All right. And so you like to ride. Do you have a favorite piece of gear working here at Gear Hut?
In store or just in general?
In general, like a favorite piece of bike gear first.
Bike gear. Well, I love my bike. My bike's great.
The bike itself, the whole thing.
Oh, I love my bike. But I just got a Deuter pack, a 30-liter bike pack for it, just so I can go on longer trips. It's been,
what is that?
A bike pack?
A Deuter pack.
So Deuter's just the brand, but it's a specific bike pack, just purposely built for cyclists. And
does it go in the frame, or where does it go?
So it's like a backpack. You just wear it on your back. Comes with like a bunch of organized pockets for bike gear, like a pump, hand pump, tubes, all that kind of stuff.
Huh. And you wear it on your back?
Yep. Oh, exactly.
Neat. And so then that's supposed to be more comfortable than like a regular old backpack.
Ideally, yeah. And it has been so far.
Neat. Okay, so that's your favorite piece of bike gear, huh?
Yeah, I like that the most, probably.
Mainly our bike section. Yeah, you have a bike section over here. Oh, a whole section. I missed this somehow.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah, so here's our bike shoes. We're currently only taking mountain bike shoes until we can get that street bike demographic up a little bit. Here's that bike light I was talking about. Connects right to a water bottle shaped battery. Yeah, speedometer, tubes, some grips. Huh. Yeah. Wow.
And then rad helmets. Like, yeah. This helmet is cool.
Definitely.
It's like super fast looking.
We got the racing helmet. This is probably actually the weirdest piece of gear I've ever seen.
Huh.
Just a racing helmet.
I have a helmet like that.
It's pretty cool. They're pretty rad.
All right, we've quickly gone from weird to cool. Thank you. I appreciate that.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, just to describe it, I'm going to tell you something that probably isn't really all that appropriate. But mine is white. And my a coworker once said, so this thing is shaped like a bullet, I guess. It's got like a big thing in the front and it tapers to small in the back, and it's got built-in glasses. And my coworker said that mine, which is white, looked like sperm. And so anyway,
appropriate for the shape of it, for sure.
It is that's weird. You're right. Anyway, but it's I think it's cool. You do absolutely feel fast.
Oh, I believe
It's interesting because these ones don't have holes in them to let air in, which I guess, makes you faster.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and the fastest sperm is the winner.
Exactly, exactly.
We all know that. We are that, right?
It can only be one.
Yeah. That was Timmy, an employee at Gear Hut. He's talking about their great deals. Here is Vanessa De Mata, Bicicletas, Bolos, e Otras Alegrías.
meus caminhos. Ajuda, ajuda.
That was Vanessa de Mata, Bicicletas, Bolos, e Otras Alegrías. That closes out our show today, featuring people from the Reno Adventure Riders, Kiwanis Bike Project, and Gear Hut, all about bike gear. I wish I had done this show just before the holidays, but hey, maybe I've given you some ideas for presents for the next holiday, right? Or a birthday or something like that. I want that leather seat, by the way, that we were talking about earlier. Is it too early to talk about the holidays? Nah, you can always be on the lookout for presents. Bike Life is produced by the Truckee Meadows Bicycle Alliance, supported by the Reno Bike Project on Grove Street, which is the license holder for this radio station, K-Wink. Wow, a non-profit radio station owned by a non-profit bike shop. It just blows my mind every time for some reason. Anyway, you can keep this show on the air, you can keep us going by making a donation to the Truckee Meadows Bicycle Alliance at bikewasho.org. 100% of the funds go to programs. Thanks for riding with me in this episode of Bike Life Radio. I'm Kai Plaskon.